her play. Off she runs. I think they've got the wriggles.
Yes, being a mom means lots of helpful hands in the kitchen. So Madeline is my new friend. She just moved to Kenya and I'm really excited to have her in my life now. She is dynamic and high energy like me, which is awesome.
She's great and could cause lots of chaos, but hey.
So today she's a guest and my house, and she's going to teach us how to make something. Would you like to tell them what you're making?
Okay.
I don't even know.
That's fine. We're going to make cayenne pepper and linseed crisp bread. So I've started off. I've made the sponge overnight, which I'll tell you how to make a bit later. But for now, we're going to just weigh out the main bit of the dough. So I've got some just white flour, which we'll just turn the scales on. And so we need 500, although I should check the quantities because I'm doing it 5 times the amount here, but I'm using 500 grams at the moment. Let's check just. And then 250 grams of wholemeal flour. And it goes. And then I need 125 of this, I think we call it semolina at home, but it's sifted maize meal, or otherwise known as ugali here. So 100 and, what are we on? We're on 75. We need 125. So,
done. From what? What do you mean? Good. Nini, Nazi, just a little bit.
Okay, next in we have 100 grams of oil. Like at home we use olive oil, but we've got this oil as well, which is great. So this is just sunflower.
I'll have some olive oil.
That's fine. And then, like, it sounds like a lot of salt, but it's because we're making a big quantity. So, got 25 then of salt. There we go.
And we've warmed our water.
And the water is ready, which is brilliant. So we need 375 grams of water. Oh, that's great temperature. Okay. Are you coming to help, Lucas? Do you have to help put the water in, look? You help put the water. Ready? Ooh, look, you can put the water in. And it's 375 grams of water or 375 mils, because it's the same, which is great. So now it's the fun bit. Okay. Now we get to mix it all together. If you grab a spoon and pour, I made this sponge last night, which is basically yeast, flour and water. So I've got wholemeal flour in there and I've got white flour in there. And I will tell you how much just in a sec because I've changed the quantity to make it more.
I think that's fine. Smells great.
Okay.
Okay, yeast, flour and water. And it's been sitting overnight.
Yeah, actually, I'll check the quantities now.
I did write down the quantities.
And then, how much did I put in overnight? It was, okay, so I used for, okay, this is for one, so I need to realize, well, for one, that's going to not make
sense. You can just do it 5 times. For one is how much?
So 7 times 5 is 35 grams, and we used
50. New calculator.
Yeah, that's fine. And then, so that's of water and 375 grams of white flour and 375 grams of wholemeal flour. And it's just sat in a bowl overnight.
Okay,
fermenting.
So that's what this is. Great.
Yeah, so that's what that is.
Gotcha.
Okay.
So, but how much effort are we adding here?
We're going to add 750 grams of this.
Okay, so set your scale.
Yeah.
Zero out.
Okay.
750 grams, which is it going to be, you think it's going to be most of it?
Yeah.
Let's see.
Probably at least half. Now, we'll probably end up needing this for about 8 minutes, so I won't make you watch it for 8 minutes. But as you bring it together, you can see it's really gloopy. So I've brought it all together, and we can tip it out on the surface. This is the really fun bit. Now at the moment, that dough is not really that smooth. So this is what you can knead it and bring it together. So we've been kneading for 8 minutes, and as you can see, the dough is looking a lot better than it was to start with. And okay, we actually add a little bit more flour, but that's because Normally I'd use strong white flour, but here we can only get an all-purpose flour, which is a bit like plain flour for us. Okay, so all we do now, scrape it all together.
And just for my American audience, the sponge, this over here, is basically proofing your yeast, only she did it overnight. She let it rest with dough overnight. So when we do our yeast and things in a cup beforehand, it's kind of like that.
Yeah, yeah. So it just gives it a bit more time to ferment and flavor and all of that. Okay. Let's
dust it with a little flour first.
All right.
And then drop it in. Heavier now than what you're used to since you're cooking a massive amount.
It happens at my house.
We have to do everything in large quantities. Great.
Okay.
How long do you let it sit?
An hour?
An hour. Okay.
Somewhere nice and warm.
Maybe here.
And then I'll just scrape this off. Okay. Well, we actually need to do after putting flour down, just empty all of this. And then we can do the important bit of adding the linseed. So, in here, I have got there's about 85 grams of linseed, so we'll need nearly all of that.
Linseed is one of my favorites.
I love it.
I just love it.
How strong is your cayenne?
It's pretty strong.
Let's go 3 or 4 teaspoons.
That much.
Okay, let's go 2 teaspoons. It must be strong.
Like this.
Yeah?
Because, yeah.
Okay.
It's pretty strong, so.
Okay, we'll just leave it at that, that's fine.
Like if children are eating it.
Yeah, that's true. Maybe I should take a bit out.
That's fine, that's fine. Try it, let's try it.
There, we just okay, now we have to incorporate it into the dough. So, now the reason we put the linseed and the cayenne pepper in later is because it stops the yeast rising. So we let it rise first and then we put it in. Okay, so we'll weigh it out with the linseeds and the flax, as you say, and the cayenne pepper. If you like it fiery, put more pepper in. But there's about 85 grams for each one. If we just sprinkle ugali down here, which again is like semolina, or you could use polenta, which is like corn maize. I've just got a pocket here for me. Now this bit, Lucas loves doing because he picks it all up, but he's having so much fun out there that like... That's it. Good patting. Should we get the bear out?
Eowyn's working on her dough. Would you like to cut one out too, like Lucas?
Yeah.
Press it down. Good. And then we lift. Help me remove all this on the outside. Look.
Right. Excellent.
Die.
So we have some very good rolling out here. Look at this. And it's getting so thin and flat, which is brilliant. And we have some more here. And then look at these. We've got some great bears, some whales, some men. And this one, we're gonna try and make an ice cream. And then we can put avocado pate in it as well. So that would be lovely. So what we need to do next is we need to prick these. And what that does is it just stops the bread or the crisp breads puffing up like with pita breads. So it just keeps them nice and flat and nice and crunchy. If you're not making animals and things like that, you can roll out your piece of dough that was about 85 grams to about 30 centimeters by about 8 centimeters and just let it rest. And it's just got a light sprinkling of ugali on it. And again, we can just go through with the fork and just prick holes like this. Then once we've cooked them, you can just snap it apart and you get that nice rustic looking crisp bread or cracker bread, as I think you call it in America. So we're just putting this in the oven, okay? There we are. And it's at 160. And I'll leave it for about 20 minutes, but I think every oven's different. So just check after it. Maybe just have a peek in at kind of 15 minutes. It's not gonna sink or anything. and then check it again at 20. And you want it so they've just kind of curled up a bit, but you don't really want the colour to be changing yet. So you want it nice and firm and crisp, but without being slightly burnt. Okay?
This is amazing rolling.
I know. Got a teamwork.
It is good.
I love having my kids in the kitchen.
As you can see, some of the thick ones are a little bit bendy still, but then they should be nice and thin and crisp like this, so they're nice and crunchy. So,
and see really like good. Emma, would you like to try one?
Would you like a snail? But we eat them with like mashed up avocado, cheese, you can put anything on.
How is it? They're really good. Ewan really likes the crisp bread. Want another one?
Would you like one?
Good. What shape did you get? Is that a bear? I think you've got a bear. But here's some guacamole. And it's really good. And I wish we had gotten it on video, but the flatbread's really good. The crisp bread is really good.
Okay. There we go. This is yummy.
Telling you, the guacamole really is good.
I like it.